Before we see the four essential qualities, let's look at the book definitions of the cloud. Because when you search on the internet, you will find a lot of definitions. Let's try to transform the knowledge that you have gained from a scenario to the book definition, so that if somebody asks in an interview, what is the cloud computing, you know how to form the sentences. The first definition is a standardized IT capability delivered via internet technologies in pay-as-you-go, self-service way is called the cloud computing. Please read it again. Standardized IT capability, that could be a server, a storage, or any other offering delivered via internet to the customers is called cloud computing. See, a standardized IT, meaning, let's say if you go to a hotel, in some places you eat food, a bill is served to you. In some places, you pay first, get a token, and the food is served to you. So there is a process that is defined. Similarly, if you go to any organization, IT company, a development team, a guy from a development team goes to a server team person and asks for a server. Just because a development team guy is a friend of server team person, he created server just in 2 minutes. Hey buddy, your server is ready, can make use of it. And on the same day, a DBA went to the server administrator and asked for a similar offering, similar server. But he denies it and 15 days passed, still the server is not created because a server administrator did not like the DBA. Is that how things work in IT? On the human emotions and relations? Not actually. So there is a standard procedure defined called service request. If you need any server, you will have to submit a ticket into a ticketing system that will go through a proper approval process. And then it will go to the service team, whoever is to deliver that service. In this case, the server administrator. And there is a standard SLA based on the priorities. If the SLA is for 2 days, and within two days, if it is not served, it will go into escalation. And they have to provide proper justification. So it's called a service request. Let's say a finance team have come to the server team, a server administrator, and said, hey, one of the application we have hosted on some X server is now not available. It is affecting our revenue directly. Would you mind looking into it? And if a server administrator replies, no, I'm quite busy in creating a server for a DBA. I cannot look into it now. So which work to be prioritized? Again, not because of the human emotions and relations, but it is an interruption to a service. So we call that as an incident. So incidents must always given priority. Then, if there is any planned change, let's say a software to be upgraded, operating system to be patched, that's called a change management or a change request. So they will submit a change request that will go through a CAB meeting, a change advisory board. Okay, there will be a set of people who will be reviewing the changes, assessing the changes, and understanding the risk of the implementation. What if the implementation go wrong? What is the rollback plan? How much time will it take? All of that. They're just going to assess and understand the change and going to give you the approval. That's called the change management. So this is all called ITIL practices. Information Technology Infrastructure Library practices. So a standardized IT capability means if you are delivering servers as a service and there is a procedure defined, a service request SLAs and the procedures have been defined, a change request procedures have been defined, problem definitions and qualifications, priority SLAs, everything has been defined. Such a service is delivered via internet to a customer is called cloud. Venkat, it's just a one-liner and you've almost spoke for 5 minutes to explain it. Is that true? Of course, I'm not creating anything here, but that's a definition, that's a change, you know what? Reading through the slides, reading a definition on the internet versus understanding the meaning of it. and the explanation of it is what makes you unique from the others. Anybody would by heart this definition and can speak of it, but explanation, a true meaning of that is what you need. And now I believe that you will not forget this definition. And cloud computing is renting resources like a storage, a compute, a networking, a monitoring from the other company. You only pay for what you use, like I've mentioned in previous slide. The company providing these services is referred to as provider. Those who are consuming is called the consumers. We have close to 60 different public cloud providers in the industry. And you know, every other company is turning into a cloud consumer. Nobody is investing money in setting up the on-premises data centers. Rather, everybody is preferring to go to the cloud. So it is nothing but a renting model. I've given you an example of renting the cars, pay as you go. So everything is turning into a rent model. You no longer invest your money to buy a server, but you are renting it. You know the advantage of renting a server? 2 days after you rent a server, if you don't like it, meaning either the server configuration is not sufficient for your application requirement or it is incompatible, you just can release that server back. When I say release the server back, you are releasing the hardware, you are also releasing the operating system licenses and the application licenses. Just assume, 2-3 years back, if you need Apache Hadoop Big Data, what would you do? You just have to invest huge amount of money, buy the physical clusters, bring them into your data center, set up them and use them. Later, if you find them not of use or not of compatibility, you're gonna do nothing but to lose all your money. In the cloud, you can try it, you know. You try it for nothing. Maybe negligible amount of money, you can lease Apache Hadoop cluster. If your POC is good, proof of concept is good, your pilot project is good, only then you can proceed with your production implementations. The cloud provider is responsible for the physical hardware required to execute your work, for keeping it up to date, meaning any updates to be done, any patches, any firmware upgrades to be done. The cloud provider is responsible. Okay, so it is Amazon's responsibility to set up a physical data center, to buy all other physical and software resources and make things available to us. And any maintenance activity to be done in any of the data centers, it is Amazon's responsibility, it is Azure responsibility, it is Google responsibility. But we, the consumers, will never bother about the physical data centers, their maintenance activities. So some of the services may vary from provider to provider. For example, AWS, they may have 180 services in their portfolio. Azure may have 160 services in their portfolio. Google may have 200. Not necessarily all the cloud provider must have the same set of services. They may be a little bit vary. So it is provider's responsibility to ensure all the software and hardware components have been provided and all the maintenance activities are performed. A consumer would just consume the services. The consumer and provider may be linked via the public internet connection or via a proprietary connection. But cloud computing as a technology doesn't mandate what kind of a connection should you use. Amazon must not say you must use Airtel internet connection, otherwise I will not let you connect. Microsoft Azure cannot say you'll have to use a Reliance internet connection, otherwise I don't let you connect. And so the other providers and the connection. So all you're gonna need is a public internet connection or a private connection, meaning a cable from your data center to the provider data center. But they don't say what type of a connection that you need. And you Google for cloud computing definitions, you're gonna find n number of definitions, but you must understand the essential meaning of it so that you make a definition on your own. You just Google for the cloud computing definitions you're going to find numerous definitions. You just have to understand the meaning of the definitions so that you make your own definitions.